No, I mean, I just think the guy's... No, I mean, I know, you don't respect that dude is you don't like Dota. Did you see his computer before he won TI?
I did. He had a CRT monitor. That was amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because I think some of the Smash organizations were looking out.
DSA, he's going to go die. Good fun. Vanscore takes down the Phoenix. Or obviously, her offlane really easily. And take a tower in the process. Not really using much. Epicenter has been used here. Not a good play, though. That Epicenter continues after he's dead, so stop walking into his corpse. Vanscore will die, though, immediately.
Kuman looking to follow up? Nope.
He has the infused raindrops, which makes Kuman realize he's a very sad boy. The Shaman stopped by the Dream Coil, but they don't catch up to the Morphling. It's just the Shaman. Those Shackles, not going to help him out. And they're going to get 3 kills for free, honestly. That was a really odd play by Rezo. He's also very weak to the Seg. That's the reason why he's strong against DP.
Yeah, they even dropped Serpent. They're going to get this tower. They want it.
I told you, dude. They're going for the push line. Now, they even caught Dendi. Dendi should be an easy kill. He was out of Illusory Orb, or he couldn't. They didn't have the mana to actually use it.
Yeah, Atlas is going to shrug at it, isn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, Dendi.
Oh,
catching
no.
Rezo. He's going to break the coil. Vanscore on the high ground. Is Lowe's going to catch the TSA, prevent the Supernova from going out? Vanscore now letting it go, but oh my goodness, he gets absolutely chunked. Sexy Fat caught in the Serpent Wars, but Lil, is he going to escape? He gets the stick off of the wand, but he's going to go down to Duster.
That man creates a true discord in your team.
It's amazing. It's one of my favorite clips of all time, I think.
Actually, that cast was awesome.
Yeah, it was great. Lil, awesome, he is going to die. He's like, well, this sucks. Can't even get the auto attacks off.
He lifts his little sticks. He's like, should I Aether Shock? Oh, I'm dead anyway. Yeah, poor Sankin. He just cannot tank. That's a good MP. Unless he gets canceled. Okay, that was a bad MP in the end because it didn't come out, unfortunately.
Dendi, though, in a bad spot.
Can they kill him? No, they've saved him with Fatigue. Duster's happy to die for this, honestly.
Yeah.
You saved Dendi, that's huge. Primal Roar for the CM. They really want to avenge Duster.
They're going to try for Roche. And that's a really big strength for this team, right? Compared to when he played the Dusa.
Yeah, that's true. Catch the Shadow Shaman as well. Rezo comes in. There's an epicenter mainly against the Puck.
Good
and
hex.
They're going to kill him in time. Great Hex before he died. Beautiful double signs as well. But Nyx doesn't have anything to follow up with. You need a Spirit Siphon. Oh, he got tricked by the Vision. All right, RDO did the in and out trick.
Yep. Yeah, the little Roche trip. You got to run over this little tiny cliff. Oh, Duster. Oh, he's most likely dead. RDO. Yeah, he's just going to drop a mirror image nearby and continue to run. Nyx.
I found the trick. Just don't be tanky and you're fine against Phoenix.
Dendi, great silence after the waning rip. Rezo to follow up. Quick kill onto him.
Nyx has been playing a solid game in this game.
I feel like, hold that thought, they're looking for a kill mid, Vanscore, Sunray, level 4 now, but again, it's not a strength hero. Counter-initiation from Rezo, the epicenter should kill TSA,
nice.
They're going to keep alive though, and Supernova to try and turn Dendi, holding down Rezo, where are you going? He's got to look into the light and take his lumps.
Right, so this is why I just mentioned this, Rezo, it's just an Indota.
I see what you mean.
Yeah, like, I don't know, maybe, I'm genuinely not sure, but I don't think it's even justifiable getting a lags for though, right? Even though I think you should copy TB and Puck. But we'll see. I'm not questioning the player's build. It's more like I want to see what he has planned because I genuinely can't tell what he's thinking about.
Whoa.
Nice Hex, though.
Yeah.
Into Snakes. They have Shackles as well.
DD for Kuman.
Okay, he doesn't use the Shackles just yet.
They've caught Rezo.
Silence. RDO finally gets out of the Snakes, but they're actually destroying both Rezo and Vanscore in the back lines. The Oracle actually is a big source of damage in that team fight, but they do stop the Puck with the Ghost Shackles, guarantee the kill. That's going to end up being a slightly beneficial trade for Hellraisers. The Puck built an E-Blade together with a Morphling, and they double E-Bladed a Kunkka with the Morphling and Puck damage. Vanscore's just going to get burnt.
Yep.
He's Ice-type against Fire-type. He's going to die, of course. No,
Rezo,
not again.
Snaps
they have
the coil.
Waiting F2.
Yeah, he has the Yules to self-dispel, but he doesn't need it.
Okay.
Not going to get flanked here as Hellraiser's. They're going to look to set up a flank and a maneuver here onto someone. Looks like they're not smoked up, unfortunately, but they're not really going to be in time to contest Roche. RDO now with a couple seconds left of the meta and BKB, but Rezo's going to try. Sunray the counter as well, but RDO is going to get the BKB off. Nyx is going to be stunned up here as well. Snap the coil. I believe Dendi now having the BKB. RDO just looking for a target. He's going to choose on to Rezo as there's going to be a great supernova. That's going to force Lil and Nyx away as now Smaiden is still going to be leashed up by the coil. Kuman in a lot of trouble, actually getting stunned by the supernova, looking to run now, as Nyx still with a little bit left here of this Exo, looking to do a little bit more damage, but yeah, I think they're just going to go for Nyx instead. Rezo's bought back, though. He's here, and there's going to be the Serpent Wards placed onto RDO. He's able to free himself very quickly, as Rezo and Kuman both now will find the kill onto Dendi. They're looking for more. E-Blade combo. They find Sexy Fett, and they even get the Phoenix.
Well, that's why you pick Aghs.
They still got good farm on RDO. You got a Morphling, who's basically the fattest person on the entire map. And it's a 4 protect 1, and here they go. But Rezo's going to get the initial jump onto RDO. Lil, though, jumping right back in on the Dendi, but Rezo forced off the BKB. Yeah, he's just dead instantly. RDO's got way too much damage, especially with the Daedalus. Skooman will be able to TP out for free. They're chasing for more, and they're going to find Lil. He's going to be silenced up, hit with the Vessel. Sunray, that's a lot of percentage-based damage. He will drop to the right clicks from TSA. As it's going to be Aegis now for TB. We have got an Aghanim Shard, actually, for TSA. Sorry, the Aghanim's Blessing.
Apparently they do. RDO just, like, charging into the mid lane. I don't know if you should be the one leading this. They just revealed the smoke, but of course they don't know where they are. Okay, the Terra Wave used. That's pretty good against Rezo, but in comes Kumen with a BKB. We need a Dream Coil for Kumen. They do get him with the Dream Coil. That should be maybe enough to kill him. The Supernova will not pop, but they will manage to kill Kumen regardless. And now Vanskor trying to dance here. Yul Scepter gonna cancel that freezing field immediately. They even stop the DP. Everyone's dead at this rate. They're gonna team wipe him unless Nyx activates his BKB, and now RDO is in a pickle. No, the false promise guarantees him, and he even murders the Oracle with a Sunder. Thank God the Oracle was prepared for that. They end up killing the DP.
Well,
whatever you want to peek at night is not my business. They do give him Lotus Orb already for RDO. That's going to be no more burst initiation. So
Okay, he's got buyback. He's got buyback.
Yeah, it's true, but he has to use it immediately or your Rex will fall. In fact, your Rex will fall regardless, it seems like. They do close an RDO with those Nyx. Nyx comes out from behind, and he's hoping to get some kills on the support. Thanks to the Sankey Burst, they might be able to. They charge the Epicenter as well, but the Supernova has been used. They pulled him in. I don't know if that's going to work out, though. He's going to lose two heroes immediately. The two supports die, hugging each other. Dendi has the A on this, but he has been silenced. Even with the A on this, he might not be able to get away. He has no more Illusory Orb, and he's trying to perpetually keep him in place as they murder RDO, the standing tower. Everyone in bait will die except for Sexy Fat. Now, is it going to be Megas versus Megas game?
Oh.
Okay. All right, I'm ready for this.
We do have two buybacks
here. If there's ever a region that's going to have Megas versus Megas, it's got to be this one.
Oh, RDO,
one.
He just wants
good
it.
Good tearaway.
He wants it.
No, but the cliff stops him. RDO, you got to get back. You gotta get back before they punish you a second time. You still don't have buyback. They walk in. DP again, cutting the line. They stop RDO. They've shackled him perpetually. They gotta cancel the shackles of this BKB on the shaman.
The false promise just
they
in time.
The false promise. RDO sunders in time as well. They've killed Duster though. Sexy Fed as well. The Supernova, can they break it in time? They don't seem to want to. This is going for RDO, and he's going to die. The damage, even with false promise, is too much. TSA also caught out. Supernova just useless. And they actually missed him because he is just not big enough. Hellraisers will proceed to get another four-man wipe.
Oh, it's so risky. Hellraisers, I don't think they want to risk it.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. I think you could just try. You don't have Exo, but that... You have a Morphling, right? Yeah, there we go. Morphling walks in. Oh, can you kill Dendi with that? No,
oh,
it doesn't press.
Wow.
Sorry, that was a Morphling. Oh, Dream Call to two. He actually deals so much damage. Is he just going to kill Rezo alone? Dendi? Here comes to save the day. 9 more seconds for the TB. Dendi.
Thrown exposed, though.
He did kill Rezo.
Kumon, I think he's going to end it. He's just going to end the game. Goes to the other side. That's going to be it. Unbelievable. Hellraisers.
They actually take this. They take this late game against a solid TB. They punish the lack of buybacks on bait twice in a row. And even when you get Dragon Blood level 2, they can still deal a fair amount of damage. Also, the Puck doesn't have to get last hit, so he can just harass you. Unless you go for Dragon Tail level 1 and you punish Duster for this really cheeky play. That's going to be first blood, or should be, as last hit comes from the DK. It's the offlane DK a lot. Because pushing the mid lane tower is kind of difficult. Pushing the tier 1 safe lane is super easy. Lil, there's Lasso. There's no way. Even without the Lasso, because they have the Shackles there. They guarantee the kill. Duster, though, could be in a similar position. Nyx even joins in and punishes the Puck.
There's no way this Batrider kills me. I have 27 regen right now.
The sticky nape almost brutal. They kill Duster though in the back lines. Nice to hit the Remnant, but it's going to be caught out with the Primal Roar plus the Hex.
Great
well
move.
Well played there.
Great moves from Bay. I don't even know. They evaded my camera as well. They just wrapped around and get the perfect
that
kill.
It's not very difficult, to be honest.
That would be like, well, I don't know about this one, but I agree.
The Meteor.
The Meteor Hammer, yeah, it's delivered. He's going to have it stun. Dendi, are you ready?
Dendi, are you ready for the... No.
Oh, he's not ready.
Oh, there we go. Yes, the power of the Meteor. And that's 16,000 stuns with a Hex to boot. Dendi could not move. He just But I think DK is a much better person at fulfilling a traditional off.
I see that point. Oh, my goodness. Big old finger of death onto RDO. They dead. Will be able to nuke him down. Nyx is going to find him. They're going to drop the Serpent Wards. That should be a very dead Vance score as they are targeting him. Duster dodging the Meteor Hember as well up from Rezzo, who's burning down in the meantime to Dendi with the five stacks of Napalm on him. The bait supports are going to get a D Ward. They're looking for more of those. The Roar now onto Lil. Should condemn him. Down he goes. Two kills for Sexy Fat. A one for three. They get the kill into RDO.
And that shows that Bait will have some trouble as the game progresses.
He's going to be scouted, unfortunately.
Shackles.
Yep, Shackles follow up. RDO is going to smack the crap out of him and say, hey, remember me? And that's going to be a kill there for RDO. He's got the meta as well if he wants to apply some pressure. If they get another kill here, then they just might. Great coil out from Duster, scouting this kill onto Vanscore. And he will go down. And that should trigger, the meta out from RDO. In response, they're going to get the glyph on top of that. Although, gank coming his way, it's going to be Dendi. Duster looking to support him as well. Dendi with the DD rune. They're going to turn, land a stun onto one. Kumin is here with the Radiance Burn. They're going to know because of that Radiance Burn as well. Silence on the two, but they've already gotten the stun on the Dendi. Now the double silence into the Aether Remnant. Nyx is here to turn the fight. And, well, Duster, he's not going to dodge the mark damage, but he's going to live a little bit longer, force them into the trees. But Kumin with the Radiance Burn is going to get it, or the big old dragon is going to kill the little old fairies.
Sexy Fat finally completed level 3. He's now building in the BKB.
He's had it for a while.
Yeah, I know, but I had to make a transition. The BKB is going to be his next item. No Blink Dagger this time for the Sexy Fat.
They might look for more, actually. Dendi rotating in on the Necro Illusion.
Yeah, the use of the Boots of Travel there. Resolution could be in trouble. Nice Dragon Tail, though. Could they set up for Dendi? No, it's only position 5 DP. I got too excited because I heard the ghosts, but in the end, Rezo. He's going to fall. Not much mobility on DK. If you get caught out in a bad position, you're just done for. And similarly, Vanscore regrets his choice to help Rezo. And I think the Aegis for RDO. I don't know if you want to give the Aegis to RDO or honestly, Dendi. Because if you lose the meta, I don't think RDO is that useful. But I guess I'm just going to give it to the carry. Play the safest possible. It's taking a while now. It's finishing this Roshan. The last bit is the hardest. Finally, the Aegis for RDO. Fights with the Reflection, but Wraith King is ready to fight as well. He himself has his own ingrained Aegis.
It's still an early death, however. Necrobook is now coming off cooldown. He can look for more, but TSA is going to drop. Big ol' crit out from Kumin.
You're going to be able to tank most of the initiation, especially with the Reincarnation. And you have some good mobility in your team to just catch up to. See, Kumin?
He's very out of position, though. I don't know if they can even kill him once.
His teammates are not nearby. They will kill him once for sure. I think they can kill him twice.
Oh, it looks like, Hellraiser's like, sorry, dude, you're out of position.
They didn't come to help him at all.
Nope.
Okay.
No, they're not even trying.
So my point is moot because...
Because they do have two quote-unquote shot callers on the team. I believe it's Rezo and Nyx. They both kind of have this very active presence in the game.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe that's kind of coming into play there because that was a little bit of a weird death roar. They maybe want to fight. Great coil, though. It's going to catch three. Shaman, though, is going to get hexed up, though, and returned by Lil. Meteor Hammer should catch Duster here, and it does. Rezo then straight onto the fairy, but Vanscore in trouble as BKB is going to be Dendi. He's going for Nyx. That might have the damage, and they do. Now they're going to turn onto Rezo, who is no match here for the Eye of Scotty. Metamorphosis TB. Three kills just like that in exchange for Duster, which is a great strength when teams are able to go for some different traps and make it work. Rezo blinking into Sexy Fat. Can they get this kill?
Now let's see. I mean, for now, Beastmaster's still stunned. They try to kill him, and they do it with the Radiance damage. And now RDO fighting without meta, though. He does use the Sunder. He has the Aegis, which is why he wants to fight this with the double damage as well. Dendi will come and help him, and he's just going to drag Rezo to his grave. Lil is also in a solo position, and now Dendi is burning down Vanscore. This man alone will kill three of Hellraiser's heroes. And this turns a team fight, which is pretty good for Hellraisers, into a win for Bait.
They're going to try. Dendi's invis, though. Pops the BKB. Hello, Rezo. How are you doing? It's time for your little Firefly appointment. Vanscore popping the ulti. They do have Lasso. Kumin just waiting for this BKB duration to end. But Dendi into the trees he goes. Rezo, he's going to burn down as well. But they do land the sun now onto Dendi. Gets the Lasso off, though, onto Kumin as they will finish off Vanscore. Sexy Fat is here as well. As TSA will finally get silenced at least. But they will be able to get the kill onto one. Nyx pops the BKB. But I'm not sure if he wants to be fighting here any longer. He actually gets roared through the BKB. That allows RDO to get the kill as Kumin was too busy respawning. Rezo's bought back, though, to get into the fight. There's going to be a big stun. The Meteor Hammer as well. It's going to connect. Put the Sunder off in time. And Rezo's dead. That's a dieback onto him. And another one, too. RDO with three kills. That's Bait. They stand their ground. They fight. And they're winning.
My goodness, dude. They're actually going for the DP as well. And I think that she bought back together with Rezo. That's going to be a dieback for Vanscore as well.
Ooh.
That clutch Sunder, dude. The Meme Hammer was good.
How did he actually get that Sunder off? Because the Meteor Hammer takes, once the Meteor Hammer is done channeling, it takes an extra half second for it to hit the ground.
Because he took too long to charge it.
All right. It's just that easy.
No, he literally, you can
no,
tell.
No, I mean, I missed it.
Lasso is really good on Wraith King because you put him out of position and punish him. First life, you don't really care because the point is killing him twice. There you go. DK walks in. There's a good hex up to the TB.
Back to BKB.
They're done with this. Primal Roar stops the Wraith King from getting away. Kuman's down. Resolution will join him in the graveyard. That means he's not going to come out. And GG with exclamation mark. They acknowledge this game is over. Pate will just take the late game. Wraith King is unfortunately just not that great of a late game carry. Like, he's really good from in at like 25 to like 45, but against a true late game carry like TB.
And against low armor heroes, so everyone but the Timber, it's damn good. As Dendi eventually will get that kill into the mid lane.
Nice, well done. Kuman just realized he took away all his mana, so that's not much he can do.
Big
Dendi
play
though,
for Hellraiser, so.
Yeah, this is a good rotation by the Timber Saw, trying to catch the poor Viper. Bye-bye to Dendi. And can they continue?
Sexy Fat
comes in. He does have Arena. Oh, no. He doesn't actually have the point in it yet. He actually put... No, he doesn't. He gets level 6, but he didn't use the Arena there.
Yeah.
I think Bait is definitely trying to put the pressure here to reduce the anti mage space, right? So you definitely want to fight yourself. There we go. The Arena Blood. Immediately into the Spear of Mars. Good Fissure to disrupt this. And they miss the hookshot. They use a Supernova in the end just to kill Rezo.
Yeah.
But if you take a tower in the process, that's worth it. Against anti mage, you need to reduce the space as soon as possible. I'm not really sure what happened there. Well, Dream Coil. Dendi. He's in trouble. That was a good silence from the Viper Strike, but he's still quite tanky though. You can't underestimate him. There we go, the Echo Slam. But that Echo Slam didn't work too well, just dealing damage to Dendi mainly, now killing off Duster in the backlines as well. And they catch Sexy Fat, who's forced to use the Arena Blood. RDO is also joining engagement, but Sexy Fat's already dead, killed off by Nyx. RDO trying to chase after the puck, but it's too difficult. Tilelapses himself away, but there's Vanskor waiting for him. However, Vanskor also not known for his stuns, while Bay's gonna try to catch him out or take towers.
Hookshot here is going to set up for the Arena of Blood. Sexy Fat perfectly falling off. They're going to commit the Supernova as well, but Kuman, he's going to jump right in. Do they have any lockdowns over the cogs, or the Thing of Beauty broken and dead is going to be Kuman, and stunned up is Vanskor trying his best, but holding him down was going to be Duster that entire time. We'll get the kill onto Duster before they go. I don't think the Secret Trough is considered much of a safe area.
I'm not going to make fun of hand tremors, do you know? My grandma has it. It's fine. I get it. Everyone has their own issues.
Hookshot
again misses. It's just a warning hookshot again.
Just a warning.
Okay,
hookshot.
We have Arena Blood, but they
silence great silence.
Yeah, and the Echo Slam as well. They keep him in place, and now they've been able to kill Sexy Fat super easily.
He got the Arena
comes
off,
out towards the end, though. And RDO's capable of murdering Lil. As RDO continues against Vanskor, a lot of burst damage. Resolution also in trouble. Timeless from RDO just to heal back up. I agree. Why is Clockwork there alone? Okay, I mean, I said they couldn't get easy kills, Puck and Timbersaw, but I think Clockwork is relatively
easy. Maybe it's a bait? RDO's here.
Okay, where's the Mars though? That's what I'm caring about. He doesn't have the Arena just yet. Sexy Fight finally reaches.
5 seconds.
For Nyx.
Another hookshot
in. Just for warning.
Got you, RDO.
Got you.
You're Nyx.
Is he gonna die? Yes, he will. Just a single hit from the Mars will do the trick towards the end.
RDO, especially with this Dragon Scale. Hookshot.
Okay, it hits. That's the first hookshot we've seen that actually connects, and they use another Toxin in time, so there's no reactive armor stacks. That's really good. But now, they don't have Arena. Can they fight this counter-initiation? This Dream Call is really good. With the Exorcism from Vanskor, dealing a fair amount of damage to Dendi. Now has to run away. Echo Slam just to guarantee the kill on Duster, and AM comes in to get the Mana Void and guarantee the kill on Dendi as well.
They're the ones that are actually getting the better of these sort of early game skirmishes and fights. Space for Kuman as well to continue farming as he is now going to find Mars. Sexy Fat running for his life. He's got a Courier coming his way. Unfortunately, that Courier has the TP scroll, which is on cooldown anyway. Is Kuman going to get distracted? No, he's got his eyes on the prize. He might even blink for this Courier. Like, he's hard countered by the puck. Super hard countered by puck. So
mid lane, we see a play by Duster. Actually, this time it catches Vanskor. Another good hook shot this time. And honestly, Vanskor's been so important in these team fights. I think it is a really worthwhile kill.
Down bottom though, Kuman blinking away. Oh, they're going to scout him. And the tree's cut down. And Sexy Fat is here in time, pinned to the edges of the map. Kuman doesn't even have the TP anymore. Hookshot just barely misses him. It grazes his skin. But Kuman into the base he goes. Blink in a second. Where has he gone? Into the hands of Dendi, who's just waiting for him. Tries to hit him with the Mana Void. Might as well. But Dendi's going to have that kill nice and easy. Yeah, RDO just pretends to run on over, and that's going to get them to back off. They're going to maybe try and trade for a Tier 1 tower. Not the worst thing, a little bit less map control, but they have now located one. Hit him plenty of times here. Rezo, though, but a great shard. That's going to allow TSA to get nuked down immediately by Kuman. Now there's going to be the jump, the shard. Dendi's going to be caught by the Aghanim Scepter upgraded leash, as he will actually snap that at the last second, so that's going to burn off his entire BKB duration here, the 10-second one as well. RDO, though, he's going to be able to find Rezo, snipe him, as the Aegis will be reclaimed. In fact, just about everyone going tit for tat here, even with their partner. Sexy Fat is a little bit poorer than Rezo, but currently dying mid is going to be Duster. No, he's going to stay alive and pinned to the wall. It's going to be Kuma. Do they have the damage, though? RDO unable to bridge the gap, but a beautiful hook shot. Duster actually hits him on the way, too, which will stun him. He's still going to get the blink off, though, as Duster will eventually be executed by the fissure. He's going for the MKB, which is going to preempt any butterfly thoughts here of the AM.
RDO.
Oh, no. They've got the follow-up stun. Oh, he's going to BKB.
There's no ags on Nyx, or is there?
There is. He's at it for a while. RDO's just going to fight, though. Vanscore in trouble. Ascendi's going to TP on in. The break into the hookshot. Beautiful out from Duster into the Nether Toxin. They've got plenty of damage here for Vanscore, who is going to go down with a bit of a fight, but eventually will die nonetheless. Just trust himself on the counterspell to hex Dendi in return.
Well, let's see. What are they going to find? The Phoenix is really valuable here. Sexy Fat, the target. Oh, they stop the Phoenix immediately. Thanks to Dream Coil and 4-step.
Does not want to fight. Okay, now he will, but he finds an illusion.
Yeah, that was a bit odd. Sexy Fat, are you sure you can fight this? Kuman activates BKB, just fights against Dendi, has to eat the cheese Dendi, but he's not surviving this at all. Kuman is just slicing and dicing him, and they're going to lose Sexy Fat as well. This really ill-advised fight by Bait, but it's the safer play. They might be going for an Exo's been used in the bottom lane just to guarantee these racks. Rez is going to be tanking this. He acknowledges he's not that strong, though. A bit too late. There's the Cogs pushing him back into the arena, but in goes Lil, and he Echo Slams with the shard as well. They're gonna kill Duster in time, but Sexy Fat has BKB activated the whole time. They lost Lil, but in exchange, they managed to at least secure Timbersaw's life. And in the backlines, they also murder the Viper. As Dream Cole catches two, AM still looking to fight. Ghost Scepter not gonna save him from the Dagon damage. Exo's still up. I don't know, Duster, dude. I don't think you're making out of here alive.
He's
80 seconds out of
They don't have buyback again.
They don't have buyback. Why? Completely useless Supernova. At this point, with an AM, with an Assault Karass and his usual reduced BAT, it's really difficult as the Phoenix to survive that because he hits so quick. He actually went for the Weaver up top. Weaver is going to die alone to the Abyssal? No, he got timeless off in time. We stole the Bastion though. RDO cannot fight against the AM.
He does that buyback.
Oh my goodness, RDO bought something before. Why? Second game without buyback. Phoenix has no buyback either. Same with gold. Clockwork is the only person who's used the buyback this game. Do these guys come from League? What's happening? Why don't they have buyback?
He doesn't have buyback. Look at Hellraisers. They're going to know. They're just going to go straight for the game.
What's happening? Kuman just got a free kill on the Weaver because he Abyssal Bladed her, or Abyssal Bladed the Weaver. Well, she already used
Sexy
the Shikuchi.
Last one to live here. Either. He doesn't have buyback.
Oh, he does. Sorry, no, he does.
He does.
He used it immediately.
But now they know no one else has buyback, so they're just going to focus the barracks.
Yeah, they know.
The Exo is ended, but again, like with Kuman here, it's just like game one. Again, another game. Bait, we're playing well. This time around, Hellraiser is playing a bit better. Dendi's going to jump in, trying to do whatever he can, but he's have to fight versus Kuman now. The 1v1, the Abyssal Blade. Dendi, he's dead. Doesn't have buyback either, but now Sexy Fat pops his own BKB. He's got the arena, but they're going to throw on the towel. They're going to strike the colors. Bait. 0-6. Two games in a row in the series where the game was right there. It was in their grasp. They could see season 2.